If we draw the failure boundaries for various theories on the same set of axes, we get the following curves for maximum normal stress theory, maximum shear stress, or Tresca theory, and distortion energy, or von Mises theory. This graph also shows the results of experimental tests for various ductile materials at failure. The first observation that we can make is the maximum normal stress theory is not a safe theory, especially in the fourth quadrant, as it predicts safety, while experimental data show failure. This was also mentioned before, and we only discussed this theory due to its historical significance and simplicity. So let's get rid of it. The other two theories show acceptable prediction for failure when compared against experiment. The distortion energy theory agrees very closely with experimental data, which shows its high accuracy. Therefore, this theory has been used as the primary method for failure analysis in ductile materials. The maximum shear stress theory shows a smaller region for safety, resulting in a more conservative predictions. This makes it appropriate to use for design purposes.